Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to our channel the AR7 Reviews. So after a long time we are back with another interesting video. Before we move on, make sure you subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Also, if you are new to this channel, do check out our other interesting review and analysis videos. So Disney recently dropped a new trailer titled What If during their huge Investor Day event, thereby finally bringing us with a bunch of hot trailers to look forward to in the Phase 4 of MCU. Like the comics that inspired this, What If presents us with alternate realities, versions of the Marvel Cinematic Universe that are either slightly or vastly different from what we have experienced in the films. It is a great idea going forward in the Phase 4, and bringing in the MCU actors to voice their animated counterparts makes the whole endeavor even more enjoyable. So without further ado, let's straight dive right into the trailer and see what we can analyze from it. The trailer starts off with animated shots, but the imagery we are seeing is familiar. There is Nick Fury, who is designed to resemble Samuel Jackson, uncovering Captain America's frozen shield, which might be presumably after Cap ended up frozen at the end of the first Avenger movie. There is Doctor Strange's Eye of Agamotto. There is Star-Lord from Guardians of the Galaxy. There is the shot of Tony Stark chowing down on a donut from Iron Man 2. And then, things change. Space, time, reality. A whispery voice tells us, it's more than a linear path, it's a prism of endless possibility. The first indication that things are not what they seem to be starts to show when Star-Lord removes his mask, and guess what? It's not Chris Pratt's Peter Quill. Instead, Star-Lord is now T'Challa, aka Black Panther. The late Chadwick Boseman reportedly recorded the voice for the character here. The changes keep on coming. The familiar pod that a lean Steve Rogers entered only to emerge as the buff Captain America opens up to reveal Peggy Carter. And sure enough, instead of Captain America, we now have Peggy as Captain Britain. But Steve Rogers isn't entirely out of the equation just yet. Meanwhile, in Wakanda, a young T'Challa ends up abducted by Yondu, voiced by Michael Rooker. The implication is clear. Instead of abducting the young Peter Quill, Yondu took T'Challa, and that's how T'Challa went down the road to being this alternate dimension Star-Lord. Remember when I said Steve Rogers wasn't out of the equation? Here he is, still in his crony form. And here is Peggy riding on the back of someone in early Iron Man type armor. Who is that someone? By all accounts, it's Steve. Instead of becoming Captain America in this timeline, he becomes a version of Iron Man. And don't worry, these two still have the same love for each other here too. Finally, we meet our narrator. I am the Watcher, he tells us. I am your guide through these vast new realities. This character has a name, you are too, and is voiced by Jeffrey Wright. In the original What If comics, the Watcher was kind of like the Crypt Keeper. He would set the story up and then it would go from there. So coming back, from here the trailer goes into the standard let's throw a bunch of quick shots in your face route that all trailers do these days. The shots themselves are mostly like the ones you would expect of the usual Marvel movies. Like Hawkeye drawing back his bow, Captain Marvel striking a pose, Bucky running around, etc, etc. So the big money shot comes near the end. Although, is it really a money shot if it was featured in a previous trailer? Probably not. But here it is anyway. A zombie Captain America. This is obviously a storyline that's separate from the Peggy Carter storyline. So you'll have multiple alternate captains' tales to look forward to. After the title card, we get a little stinger. All throughout the trailer, there are various shots of Doctor Strange doing stuff. I honestly have no damn idea what he is doing, other than waving his hands around and being mystical. But none of it seems particularly different from what we expect from the character anyways. This final beat finally clues us into what's going on here. Doctor Strange ends up fighting with none other than Doctor Strange himself. Only this other Doctor Strange has a bunch of red glowing magic at his disposal, which suggests that he is evil. How does all of this work? We will have to wait and watch. So What If premieres summer of 2021 on Disney Plus. So that's it guys, this was our analysis regarding the trailer. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up by hitting the like button and also comment down your feedback, suggestions as to what videos you would want us to make going forward. Thanks again for watching, see you next time. Until then, stay safe, keep supporting, peace out.